and welcome back to Let's Make Merle, a character for the Kickstarter video game Gray Skies, Dark Waters. In the previous episode, I went ahead and kind of made a base texture for the face, just kind of trying to get it look a little bit not terrible. So now I'm gonna go right on and try and keep painting on the hands and see if I can get them looking better. As you can see, I've collected some reference here. These are just some basic images of hands. I'm a little uncontent with... I'm a little unhappy with this picture, since you can kind of tell it's male hands, but it's got some really nice wrinkle reference, so I decided to put it in here. And then we've got the palm right here, and a reference here for just some kind of like a general color reference. So, see what happens. So, let's see here, we've got where we left off. We've got, what's this layer? What is this? What did I do here last time? Okay, so this is the wrinkles. And I think it'll probably make sense to just continue sculpting on this layer that I have right here. And let's see, we've got, take that size down, put this here. Okay. We're gonna turn off metal, gonna turn on height. I'm gonna take the height down a bit, because I think maybe just start off with some basic wrinkles. Just kind of start defining the basic shapes. It looks like pretty reddish color. So I'm gonna see, can I actually just pick this? Can I pick this color? Looks like I can. Well, that's really nice. I'm gonna take the roughness up a little bit, just because I don't want it to be red glossy, and see how this looks. The color's not very saturated. I'm gonna take that up a little bit. Let's see. Okay, maybe a little bit more. Yes, now it is getting that right side of texture. Let's see if we can. Yeah, that is the kind of indent I'm looking for. This is just some really basic noise, just to. I don't like putting that much work into hands, since hands can just... I could put a million years into just sculpting really good hands, and I have done that. And I actually, for the previous models, what I used, and please don't murder me for saying this, but I used 3D scans for the hands, because they are... Hands take a long time, and I've made really nice hands before, and there's no real reason to, in my eyes, keep doing the same thing over and over, since, hands are hands, and, yeah. At some point, I'm gonna do a lot of hand studies. I keep on telling myself that so I can learn them. And I feel like I can sculpt them enough so that, I get a nice, I can sculpt them enough to get hands, like, right now when I need them. So, just sculpting the wrinkles and stuff like that. So, here I'm just kind of focusing on getting the base wrinkles in here with my super standard brush. I'll switch here over to the base reference. I can looking at that. So I always want to be looking at that reference! And what I've noticed is inside the wrinkles when you sculpt them is that generally tends to be a little redder, so that's why I've switched to my reddish indentation brush, which is just the standard brush made really small, which you saw me set up. So yeah, just continuing sculpting that, giving the hands a little bit more, just that little bit of definition, which will hopefully take them. Give it a little bit of believability. And again, there's never going to be any close-up on the hands, so this is really just to... let's see if I can get a better environment here. Something with a little bit of ground. I mean, think the airport, or maybe the studio lighting here. Oh, loading a studio, it's taking forever! Okay, there we go. Yes, that is what I... got some wrinkles going like that. Maybe if I switched the...
Fuck! I forgot to turn on symmetry! Oh no, what'll I do? What'll I do? Fuck! Fuck!
Okay, I'm gonna erase everything and start over. But hey, we had a really good starting point. I want these to be symmetrical, and if I now start painting symmetrically, I won't know what will be on one hand and the other hand, so... I'm gonna just redo that. And turn on symmetry! There we go. And I'll switch back to my... There we go. That's... That was unfortunate. But I just figured it's gonna save more time just to redo it. Plus that was just my warm-up phase. That's just my warm-up. And let's paint all this. These hands are directly from Make Human. I did absolutely zero sculpting because, again, I get so carried away sculpting hands, it's just a huge time sink. And I do want to make a bunch of characters. And I, especially for Gray Skies Dark Waters, I've got one more character to do. And then I'll be free so I can do personal projects again. This is obviously a personal project and I want it to look good, but for their intents and purposes, they are really trying to get the show on the road. So, since we're never going to have a hand close-up, it would be just a huge time sink and kind of wasted time, including... And since they're kind of like my clients, obviously, they're not paying me since this is... I'm doing this for love. It's... Yeah.
Bigger.
Switch back to the knuckles and see. But yeah, since I'm doing this for love, but they are still kind of a client, I am not going to be wasting their time. Because I don't like wasting my time or anybody else's time. So, just trying to work on the most effective representation of the model. Finding that fingernail, finding this joint. Wait. And got a joint here, and then you've got a joint here, David. And wrinkles like joints. Find one with even more bottom light, but that seems to be it. For some reason I have all my environment things twice because I think I copied them over from Substance Painter 1 into the same shelf folder, so kind of awkward. Don't like how that, how it kind of like made this huge dent there all of a sudden. Of course, something that'll be very important, which I'm already kind of looking forward to, is the nail polish, because I think that's one part where I really want to kind of mirror the nail polish I used for her sister, which was the sort of bright pink, so Merle's gonna be getting some pink nail polish, which is gonna make me super happy. Get that family nail polish. Okay, so we've got this. It's always a very defining sort of line. So I'm gonna paint that in here, and then paint this. Just trying to get it organic and fold BE. Even though we're working with a make human. Yeah, so this brush that I'm using, it's very kind of like trying to get that same itch. Kind of like that red dot, but it's not where I want it to be. It's kind of got that, it's itching that same itch as the Damien standard in ZBrush, which is one of my absolute favorite brushes of all time. And continuing with finding some wrinkles here. Dun, 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 dun. Wrinkles are so fun. Makes me so happy. Let's get this really kind of worked out wrinkle here. I'm gonna have to research in another in between videos about how to turn off this solo flickering because it's driving me crazy. I don't like it. I don't like it. I mean, maybe it makes it a bit faster, and if that's the case, is that the solo flickering is giving me a performance increase, then sure, I'll keep it because I want all the speed I can get while painting, but it is annoying as fuck. I'm already calling it sculpting, just trying to get that base skin texture on some really soft folds, just to... I really am trying not to overdo it with her hands, simply because she is, like, a small girl, and they don't have super wrinkly hands yet, small girls. Thank you. for some base coloring in a second to get those more defined. But I think the wrinkles there are just kind of nice landmarks to have before switching to the more intense color. Also, as you can see, I now own Substance Painter 2. Basically, since it hasn't crashed yet at all, I consider that a massive improvement, and that convinced me to buy it. Oh, fuck. Speak of the devil, and of course he will come to you. Something just happened, which is very wrong. I zoomed. There we go. That was odd. Okie doke. Now, I'm gonna go back onto this paint layer and paint in some redness. Oh, or paint it out. Let's see here. See how much. So, knuckles. A bit of that. And for this, I'm actually gonna go ahead and take one of those artistically brushes. Maybe a sandpaper brush. Yeah, that's giving me a nice uneven texture. I'm gonna kind of take away some of the center and start off with some real basic. This, I want it to be no roughy. Oh, wait a second. Maybe we can just make the base skin a little rougher. Because it's just a little too sweaty for my taste. There we go. Yeah. That little bit of texture, that little bit of fluctuation in the painting here is already giving me an effect that I'm really kind of getting happy with. Side of a model. Like when one little misclick and then it puts me to the furthest reaches. Eyeballing it. No. Basically what happens is the camera goes inside of the model, like inside this part here, and then I click inside the model and that sets the rotation point to be inside of the model, and then it's just bad. I think that's what's happening. I don't know what you could do as a developer to not make that happen. I really don't know what there would be one could do, but it's annoying as fuck. There we go. This is already looking a lot better. Just a little bit of color variation. Already doing wonders. That looks alright as a base texture. Now what I'm going to do is gonna look like a little bit of an artistic, maybe. Let's just go with this base artistic brush and kind of make it super small and accentuate the white areas in between the wrinkles. Take my flow down. It's always way too high by default. Like, I don't know who could ever sculpt with a flow like that. And just paint a little bit over these areas. There we go. Real soft. Not overdoing anything. And also, actually I might as well paint in the fingernails here. Just as a sort of a base, and then afterwards put on the fingernail polish, which could have a kind of a cool effect, because that's how it kind of works in real life, is that it's super, super white on the fingernails. And plus this way I can already define them a little bit. No, it got me. There we go. Phew! Some action. Because this is a let's make, let's play, you always have all these action moments where, you know, shit happens and people get super scared. And, like, YouTubers get super scared. That's what happens when in this. Let's make is I get super scared when I go into the mesh. I'm like,
help! Help me!
Yeah. A little bit of back and forth variation. This looks. I'm happy with this as my hand, but. I'm gonna go in and add some more little bit of a. Spots, and then I think it'll be done. I know there's a pink spray spots thing. Where are you? No, that's not the one I want. I think I'll just go with dirt then.
Okay.
Let's get a little bit more fleshy fleshed. There we go. And a little tiny bit more variegation. Not leprous spots, just a tiny bit of more for the skin variation. There we go.
Ah! No, I'm in the level! Help! Ah! I can't find myself! I'm lost!
Ah. Oh no, that's... Press the Alt key. There we go. Man, that was a close one. Almost got lost in that model for a bird. Oh, that's way too much flow. Had a bit too much there. There we go. Nice, 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 nice. Okay, now I'm gonna go in and add some nail polish. Gonna make a new layer for this. Actually, no. This could be a fill layer. That would make sense. Add a new fill layer. Nail. Polish. It is Polish nails. And they will be pink like her sister's nail polish. Kind of like that. It's gonna be not completely. There we go. And now we will add a black mask to this and paint on that mask with a default soft brush. Or maybe even a hard brush. Because. There we go. I think I will have to make this. Actually taking it out just a tiny bit. We're actually taking it in a bit. Little effect in the height channel. And let's try and make it a bit darker. That's a little too much, isn't it? Yeah, those are the nice sparkly girl nails that I grew up with. Well, I had four sisters, so I did kind of grow up with it. Actually, I don't know how I feel about that height. Maybe I should just leave the height. Should take it out a bit, yeah. It's looking better, and then I will go and sculpt in another couple wrinkles around that snail. I'm gonna switch a little demand of this nail, brush the mask on. Still lay it. Paint on some nail polish. Now if I had the resolution I might put a little bit like some sparkly stars on the nail polish. That could be pretty cool. But I don't think that I have the resolution or the pixels, you know. Pixels for that kind of silliness. Oh, paint our nails here. This is so fun. I wish painting nails was this easy in real life. Just kind of splat some paint on there. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna need to paint some wrinkles. And then a bit of the ace color, make it real dark, and take that height down. Just to add some little fake shadow into them nail polish. Too dark. It's gonna undo all that. I need a bit lighter. A bit redder. Oh, definitely way too red. I really like just painting a couple pixels here, which are being that defining thing. Definitely could use a tiny bit more resolution. Maybe I'll export it with more, but I know that something that I kind of set this resolution this low intentionally so that I don't lose myself in too many details, as mentioned before. She's biting her nails a bit. That's fine if they look a little janky, just because I know biting nails is a real problem a lot of people have. Not me. I have got very non-bitten nails. But I used to bite my nails as well, so stopping that is a really, really difficult thing to do. But you can do everything if you set your mind to it. Was after I quit a lot of unhealthy habits that I also quit biting my nails. So you don't need any of that. You just need yourself and love. There we go. Yeah. I am happy with those hands. I am happy with that. Happy, 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 joy, joy. I'm wondering if I can do anything else to this face. I think, actually, using some of that speckleness I was painting it just a second with, I really like that, so I'm gonna try and add some more speckle, like skin speckle variation. Just a tad, and that flow! Always gotta fix up that flow, so always wants to give you too much. Just get a little bit more natural. I could even take this and put a tiny bit into the roughness, because I want it to be less rough in the parts where it's redder. And I also want the height to be just a little bit less, just so you can get a little bit more height variation there. Because the red parts are generally a little further in. Ooh, and now we see here. I do want to have. Okay, maybe the height was a little bit. Let's not make it affect the height. Just the roughness. Because the roughness, that's a little, that makes more sense. The height, I was kind of hoping to get a little, kind of some free detail there, but it didn't quite look right. I'm not painting. Sometimes my brush is set so soft that I don't notice that I'm not even painting. Kind of coming with this. Don't want her to look leprous. Want her off symmetry. Yep, just a tiny bit of variation there. And turn my flow down. More variation there too. carrying the hand. I think next thing I'll do is move on to... I'm going to just give this staff jacket some nice masks, because got that nice zipper here. Oh, I actually got to load my... save this and puree and now go ahead and load my Merle. I'm gonna switch back to my references here. And it's a white zipper, but I think what we can do is get it that white kind of like a painted white metal zipper, and then get a little bit of a glossiness, kind of a sheen onto it. So let's see how. Oh, they're all double. Oh god. Steel painted. Yeah, try and get some of this. And I'm gonna go right ahead and add a mask with a color selection on that. Pick the zipper color. Cause that way it only has to do that and increase the tolerance a bit. Yeah. Now, of course, I want to make this paint white. Yeah, it's a really subtle kind of like material difference, but I think having a little bit of that metalness in there is just, I like it. I'm gonna go ahead and do this color selection map also. Aww, no. I'm gonna just have to, I guess, add a paint, add the paint to this, and then switch to my default hard. Go down with that. Paint this little button as part of that, because it's just adding a nice little bit of variation, I feel like. I'm going to go to this color section and also add this color. There we go. Since I didn't have that earlier. And what I also have is I've got this mask of the inside, and I think it would be kind of cool to maybe get a sort of a clothy material onto that. So let's see here. Fabric. Or maybe I could just do it as a base fill layer. Damp, make a base color, make it darker. A little bit of this is all kind of making stuff up as I go, but I think it'll look good. I think it'll look good. A bit white, but maybe make this super rough. Get the height down. Ooh. I do like taking that height down a little bit. Like that. Now let's take this color selection and make it very unhard. It's not doing anything. Well, what I can do is add a filter on top of this color selection and just kind of finished brush. These are some new filters. This is pretty cool. What does this do? Did it do it? Material effects selected is not compatible with this content. I see. Oh, that's sad. I'm gonna blur that. There we go. Yeah, so kind of blurring that fake plastic. And yeah, I already like how it's picking that, but I'm gonna get a little bit more of an exciting environment real quick. Try that glazed patio, get some colored lighting. Yes, I do like this. That's really elevating the jacket to a new level. Oh, and the hair is looking fine. Maybe add a little bit more blur. It's not gonna help. Makes it look like sewn onto something shiny underneath. I'm gonna go ahead and take it like a little bit less metallic and a little bit rougher. Just to kind of fine tune it. Yeah. This jacket is so sexy. Just the materials of this jacket. I'm so happy with it. Okay. What else? I'm gonna go ahead and make this button a little bit of a metal button on the pants. Let's add a, kind of a button is that? Can't really tell. Since it's like a chrome. No, that's not a chrome button. That is a rusty. Steel rusty? Nah. Bronze armor could work. Yeah, bronze armor button. That could do it. Gonna give her bronze armor pants. Just kind of excited about how this will look. Oh yeah! Oh man, I want pants like this. Oh man, those pants are so fab! Yes! That is looking so good. Done. These are, she gets fab pants. No, we're gonna make it boring. It's fucking just... Oh, I did not bake the ID map. Tell you what, ID map baking is the boring as fuck procedure, so... Yeah, it does need an ID map. So I'm gonna pause the video now and make that ID map, and then I'll, when we return for the next session, we're gonna go ahead and start detailing the pants, and I've got a special surprise. As I've downloaded some pretty cool pants Photoshop brushes, which I found somewhere on the internet, which we can then use as alphas for kind of like the frayed sections of the pants. So I'm really kind of excited to try that out. Anyway, hope you enjoyed watching this video. I will see you in the next session.